winner doesn't know.
Winner don't know.
The gambler understands. Whether you like it or not, we're all going to go through this.
I'll take my chances on you.
Sticking your head under the pillow isn't going to help you. The International Crime Syndicate is coming straight on for humanity. They need world collapse to set up world government so they can dominate and control the future and carry out their eugenics programs unhindered. And that means killing us with controlled cancers and other bioweapons releases. They cover up the medical system through compartmentalization. That means intensified chemical and biological poisoning to the water supply. Continued intensified propaganda and mind-washing of the public. I know I have a pretty frightening view of reality, but my view is the accurate one. In fact, it's far worse than I can even describe to you properly. They are coming straight on for you. They're going to give us no quarter. You know what that means? They've pulled a huge cutlass on us. They've thrown one down on the floor in front of us. And if we don't pick it up, they're still going to go ahead and hack us to pieces. So you might as well go ahead and fight in the information war. You know, some days I get up here on air and I talk about that case with the information clearinghouse fella. He and his wife in their house, men in suits come in and threaten to kill him if they don't shut up and stop publishing what they're doing. And, you know, on that day I say, well, if they didn't identify themselves, I just grab a butcher knife out of the cupboard and, you know, plunge it into one of them. Then on another day I get on air and I say, you know what, if the enemy walks up to me and wants to gun me down, I'll let him. And that shows the duality of the mind. But my point is that I'm not looking for a fight. I don't want to fight. And in a Gandhi-esque view, it exposes them. It makes them look bad. It exposes their tyranny to let them, in some cases, abuse us and go after us. But, you see, this isn't some British empire in India, or this isn't a Hitlerian system in Russia when they were taking over there, where resistance was absolutely needed in every case. This is scientifically crafted where every stage has been planned for. They intend to implode the economy by design. They intend to get everybody basically on welfare with a government ID card that has their cash creds on it. And then you'll have to, you know, have a government certified job, even if it's in private industry, because those private companies will be federally funded. That's what this bailout's about. How many years have we told you? Get everybody in debt, implode the economy. When they finally fully devalue the currency, pump all its final value into their real assets to accelerate consolidation, and then shift the economy over into a new deal, but not a new deal building dams and electrical plants and roads and rest stops and city buildings and state buildings. No, ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be spying, policing, checkpoints, prison guards, data scanning, analyzing data. That's what the colleges are turning out now, is data mining and spying on you, and industry by law having to report on everybody. And web censorship and armies of people in there censoring the web. By controlling the economy, they can then make people come hat in hand to do almost anything just to get food, because now everything has been so centralized and most of the family farms and ranches have been shut down. Most people sold off most of their land. They might hold 20, 30, 40 of their original acres of huge farms they had previously in ranches, and then they work in town. And then as things implode, they won't even be able to be self-sufficient. And later in the next hour, I'm going to play part of Zeitgeist Addendum. I want to analyze it. I agree with some of it, disagree with a lot of it, because it's a lot of what I've discussed, but I want to look at the flaws in the kind of progressive liberal socialist view through the lens of technological development. So that's coming up later. The rest of this hour and a little bit of the next hour, Paul Watson is going to be joining us, and Ted Anderson in a few minutes. But let me just give you some of the financial news, and then I'm going to get into the nerve gas helicopters waiting for you and your family. I'm going to get into the neutron bombs waiting for you and your family. How the enemy plans to do this step by step, what they plan to carry out, and then the desperate chance we've got to defeat them, but only if you fully activate as info warriors savagely, spending at least 10 hours a day after your workday fighting the New World Order. It's simple. We can defeat the enemy. I've analyzed many weaknesses in their attack pattern, though it's the most vicious and wide-ranging and most well-thought-out ever seen, known as the scientific dictatorship by MIT, by the Pentagon, by the brains in London. Their attack profile is public. They have stated what they're doing, ladies and gentlemen. We have ways to defeat them. But we have to act now in this phase. It will be near impossible 5 years into this. 5 years from now, if you haven't mobilized today, like your very life depends on it, there is no hope. And years from now, you will remember what I said here on air long after I'm off air. Because if this continues, I won't be on air. I would give it 12 months, maximum. This show will not be allowed to go out. If people don't get their heads screwed on straight, if all of you don't activate and get very aggressive and very vocal in the info war, it is going to break down into an ongoing civil war. The whole anti-Al-Qaeda, anti-system was set up for enemies over there that were manufactured when it really is about attacking the American people. And they want us to fight. They want us to kill police and military. They want that further breakdown, and I'm going to explain that later. We have to stop it now. Now, the bankers own the banking system, and they're going to do what they're going to do with Congress. Congress was threatened with martial law last week if they didn't pass that. We're in martial law. When the White House threatens martial law, that is martial law. That's what PDD 51 is. And when Congress acquiesced to the terrorism, they signed the contract. But with a gun to their head, a literal gun to their head, they signed it saying, okay, you've got financial dictatorial power. Fox guarding the hen house, ex-Goldman Sachs executive to oversee bailout. We're going to go over that. Gold rush is bullion, has a glitzy future, Daily Express. Another report here from CNBC, gold prices to double on paper market default. You may not care about paper market defaults, but you should. We'll tell you what that means. Bankers want world economic government to solve financial crisis they created. They're openly admitting they created it and that they want to have the consolidation. The Financial Times of London a year and a half ago said that in multiple stories, letting everybody know, don't worry, we're controlling this. Don't worry, it's the International Bank of Settlements 2 years ago said that. They are engineering it. And in the high-level banking documents, some of which have been leaked, some of which are public, fragments of which have been reported on, they admit it. But that's not for general consumption. What we do is we bypass that and get into the white papers, where they say they got nerve gas for you and your family. This evil government has got crews standing by to spray every city with opiate gases. That is declassified. Sunshine Project 2000, February 2000. Got those documents declassified. Can you imagine what is classified? Well, we know it's nerve gas. Now, if they spray a city, say of a million, with opiate gases, only take about 20 helicopters and two runs. They say that within a few hours, more than 10% of the population will die. You'll fall, you'll hit your head. Cars will wreck. There will be fires. The fire department won't be able to fight them. So you're talking about killing 100,000 people if they spray an entire city. And folks, don't think they won't. If they think we're about to overthrow the government, they are going to launch helicopters and they are going to spray our cities. You will see a helicopter coming down. You'll see fires in the distance, smoke. You'll see helicopters flying grid patterns. And if you don't have gas masks on your loved ones and on your family, of course, they'll be at school. And folks, you see, I'm not joking about this. Now, I'm not saying they'll use those, but that's how evil the people that have hijacked our government are. That it was declassified 8 years ago, they're ready to nerve gas us. Okay, I'm going to get into it later. And again, the big British Ministry of Defense report last year said governments will use neutron bombs on their own population if they try to overthrow them. You say have a march on Washington? You say have a march on London? A march on Berlin, throw the criminals out? They're not turning anything over. Now, sustained national strikes are ways to do it. But then again, they'll shut down the alternative media and then badmouth everybody and then let the public starve there. But that's better. Just saying no and walking away from things where the police and military have to come to their senses and then have an open discussion from the cities, taking over the broadcast systems with the federal government, with the criminals that have taken control of it, and saying, look, dismantle it. We want to have an open discussion instead of you lying. We want to have open discussions with you. We want to have, and then you might have an open debate about it.